Now that we understand X-ray crystallography, let's introduce a new technique, co-crystallization. And we'll see actually a PDB entry of a co-crystallized structure. A very useful tool in protein crystallization is called co-crystallization. Protein crystals are grown from a solution of protein. The crystals can then be studied by X-ray crystallography and we'll get our X-ray structure. If the protein solution also contains a molecule, so this is the scheme on the bottom, protein plus drug solution, then when the protein crystallizes, the crystals may include both the protein and the molecule. These are called co-crystals. More exciting, the X-ray structure of the co-crystal will show exactly how the molecule interacts with the protein target. Let's see an example. We're looking at the web page for PDB entry 1086, and that O is a letter O, not a zero. This protein is angiotensin-converting enzyme, or ACE. This protein is an important target in the biological pathways that regulate blood pressure. Let's click on the structure link and bring up the structure. And I'm going to change our viewer to NGL. It's in the bottom right corner. And here is our cartoon form for this protein. We can click and drag with the left mouse button and rotate the structure. We can zoom in and out with the mouse wheel. And if we right click and drag, we can transpose the structure in the window. If we look down into the protein, it's hard to find a view. There's a good view. Zoom in. There's a molecule hidden here in the middle. That molecule has been co-crystallized with angiotensin-converting enzyme. That molecule is lisinopril, an approved drug for treating high blood pressure. It may be no surprise that lisinopril acts by binding angiotensin-converting enzyme. This picture is nice, but let's try to focus on the interactions between lisinopril and the protein target. Let's click on the Ligand View tab, and we will select our ligand, our molecule. Our ligand is LPR, that stands for lisinopril. Great, lots of stuff disappears. We only see the vital parts for these interactions. So let's scroll in to zoom, and you'll see lots of lines. Most of these lines are between the atoms in lisinopril and the surrounding protein. And I admit, it takes some practice to get used to looking at these structures. But the program is showing us every possible interaction. If we hover over some of these lines, and here's a nice one. This is a line between lisinopril and one of the amino acid residues. Just hover over that. That is a hydrogen bond. That's a hydrogen bond between a glutamic acid residue in the protein, and lisinopril, a nitrogen on the lisinopril. Notice that nitrogen atoms are shown in blue and oxygens are in red. If our goal is to design a molecule that maximizes the interactions between a drug and a target, you can begin to appreciate the value of having co-crystal structures that can illustrate how other molecules interact with that same protein. So in this video, we saw how co-crystals provide really valuable information, and I can't emphasize enough, in a target-based drug discovery program, this type of structural information about how two molecules interact, the protein molecule and the drug, is really critical information and very helpful to accelerate a discovery program.